Hello there everybody, Embrix here, back with another LEGO review, and today we are reviewing the LEGO Avengers Infinity War Marvel Bricktober Pack. So there's quite an interesting story about this now. We call it interesting, though a lot of us got worried for a long time. So this came out in October of 2018, and basically what happened is that Toys R Us shut down. Toys R Us was supposed to receive this as a promotional item, but it shut down, so we were also worried of where to get it. And then finally, after like, I think 6 months, I think this happened either May or April. No, I think it was March, actually. That if you said $75 or more, you get this for free. And not only on Marvel superhero sets, like everyone thought, but on just any LEGO sets. And this is a great promotional item. Removing that sleeve so you can't really see my reflection anymore. But this is nice, the sleeve right here. And I just love this, and just the packaging, you know, this thing just looks great. Like, it says limited edition on it, that just makes me feel good. And then I love the box art, like, all those nice details. Thanos right there in the corner saying Infinity War. Yeah, this came out closer to the time of Endgame, to be honest, and this is so great. And, you know, these figures came pre-built in the box, which is how you know this is limited edition, and pretty good quality. So now let's take a close-up look at each one of them, though I do not have my minifigure stand, so I don't know, it's gonna be a bit messy, but let's try to do it. Going in order from left to right, this is War Machine, or Rhodey, Mark IV. This was from Infinity War, not from Endgame. In Endgame we got that dumb quantum suit one. Rhodey looks great. Just look at this detailing on him, not just the helmet, which we'll go on to, but that leg printing. Look at all those different levels of color and detailing. You got that nice silver metallic shine. You got that dark gunmetal gray. You got a lot of red intertwining in it. That just looks so great. And then you got that quote-unquote arc reactor. He even has sidearm printing saying 004 for the Mark IV. And then there is kind of the War Machine sign. He has this mounted gun on the side. And this helmet piece is so detailed. Like, look at that printing right there. Like, this figure is just gorgeous. And then we got this face, and oh my god, the heads-up display. That is so amazing. Like, now we got it in, like, the War Machine Buster kind of set from Endgame. But before that, you know, this was the first and only way to get the heads-up display War Machine. So this figure is great. Removing the mounted gun, we get a great look at that back torso print, and that thing is just gorgeous. Look at all that amazing detailing. This figure, LEGO really outdid themselves on. And then we got Wong, our first LEGO Wong ever. Now, he was missing from the Doctor Strange sets, and then everyone was so hopeful that we'd get him in the Sanctum Sanctorum Showdown, but then he was missing there, which was really mean, in my opinion, of LEGO to do, but now that we finally get him, this figure's great. Now, people are complaining that he has super short hair. He should get the Finn hairpiece. I think that that's a bit bulky, honestly, and I'm happy with the decision LEGO went with. His facial print, I think, is kind... I don't know. I like it. It's just that... And I'm not saying because the actor's Chinese, it looks like fake LEGO, which is made in China. I'm just saying the eye style is very much like that of fake LEGO, with the... pupils that are a bit bigger than usual and that really stylized eyes. But I think that it's a good look. And then again, that torso print. You see that nice maroon color? You got that belt there, and then that kind of strap going through the middle. That those legs actually are dual molded, so that looks amazing. Even side leg printing, like, this figure's great. You got this super cool accessory. Well, not super cool, but this figure's great. You got that kind of book, and then just a strip of black going down the leg. That's just added detail. And then, because he has nothing covering the back, that's his back torso print. So another great figure, and it's the first time we're getting Wong, so that is great. Next, we come to Tony Stark in his jogging suit from the early moments of Infinity War. And he has a really nice facial expression. I do not think it is exclusive, however. I think it came in some of the Iron Man 3 sets or Age of Ultron sets. Pick any set Iron Man was in, probably in one of those. Okay, so this torso and legs are super cool. You see that army man or army camouflage kind of print? See, when it hits with the light, you get that shine because it's printed very subtly. It's gray on gray, but the kind of camouflage gray is like a lighter gray. And then he really has that nice printing all over his body. It just wraps this figure up. And then, you know, you see the arc reactor and the jacket detailing, that hairpiece, which, I don't know, I think the Superman hairpiece works better, but that's just me. You got that arm and that arm, and then you can see the hood at the back as well as some more printing. And that is the alternate face. It's just him kind of scared, which is nice because now that we just get the heads-up displays, I needed just a regular Iron Man face, so that's super cool. Last up here, we have Bucky, or the Winter Soldier, or the White Wolf, and he was infamously, missing from the Infinity Wars. That's so used to saying Endgame now. He has that hairpiece, which I think always framed him pretty well, that nice new facial expression for him with all that nice kind of detailing, and then you get that torso print with which has that fine lining and detailing, dual molded legs, two straps. You got that new metallic arm with that nice gold on it, that gun, and then some side leg printing as well. And then here you got the back torso print and this kind of more angry expression. So these figures are all just great. This is just a great promotional item. Like, come on, four figures in one box set that is pre-built in for you. Like, this is probably one of the greatest promotional... I think that this is, in my opinion, the greatest promotional item ever from LEGO. Not in terms of, like, what you have to pay or do to get it, which, also, $75, I actually did, like, $125 you have to pay to get this for free. So, yeah, this is just a great item. All these figures are so detailed. It's funny to me that they're even more detailed than figures that go into sets. But I definitely recommend this if you could get it online. It goes for like $80. And I kind of understand why, because, come on, this is a great pack. But I don't... $80 is steep. But if you're a Super Marvel collector and you find it for $60, I think you should go for it. But yeah, that's it for this video. I hope you liked it. And if you did, please subscribe, leave a comment down below, and I'll talk to you again soon. Bye.